Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to use the EXMATCH function in Microsoft Excel. So by the end of this video, you should be able to return a number up here, like we have in C1, with the order of what we are searching for in column A.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So if I click in C1 and I type equals XMATCH with a left parenthesis, the first argument I'm going to be prompted for is a lookup value. So let's say I want to find Puma right here. So in double quotes, I'm going to type Puma. And if you don't want to type Puma with the space and the CO, I'm just going to put a star because that's going to allow for a wildcard character. So I'm just going to look for whatever starts with P-U-M-A. So you can choose not to use this wildcard and just put in the exact wording that you're looking for, or you can put in part of the wording and use this star as a wildcard. So I'm going to close those quotes and type a comma.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
My next argument is my lookup array. Where is all my data? Well, in this case, I'm going to highlight A2 all the way down to A11. And then I'm going to type a comma. And the next argument I have here is match mode. So in this case, because I use the wildcard, I'm going to want to put a 2 for the option that allows for the wildcard. If you had hard-coded everything you wanted to search for in the first argument, then in this case, you would put a 0. But because I used a wild card, I'm going to put a 2. And then I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that I'm being returned with the number 7. So let's see why. If I click on my first record here, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then my 7th one is where Puma was found. So if I go up here and I put in Nike, even though I have 2 of them, and hit enter, I can see that I'm being returned with a 3. Because by default, Excel will pick 1, 2, 3, my 3rd one here. Before it even gets to the 11th one, it will look for the very first one in the data set. So we go over the nuances of this a little bit more out on our blog, and I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.